Hey, this is Lily, and welcome back to Lily's Raw Reactions, where over here I give you my raw reaction. And some people like it and some people don't. And guess what? It looks like it's more people that's liking it and feeling us and liking it. Okay? So, yeah, let's get into this reaction. So, I'm over here minding the business that pays me, working on a little something, trying to, upload a video, trying to get some shit started, because I woke up with the shits today. I'm like, fuck this, I gotta say it, somebody gotta say it, let's go, let's get it. And I clicked over here to get me a thumbnail, and I see Strong Mommy Chrissy then went live. She done went live, and I see Rod on the scene and everything, so I'm just looking and everything, and I hear Rod come to the front. And if she was just so left field, I was just like, had my mouth open. And he was like, "Little bro, this to Chris. Big back to big booty, big wide ass nigga. I'ma need you to respect me and mine and keep my baby name out your mouth. My love. Okay? Keep my love name out your mouth. Baby. And congratulations on your new baby." What the fuck? That one liner, congratulations on your new baby. And he dropped the motherfucking mic. I was like, what the baby? Y'all know I don't be feeling Strong Mommy Chrissy lives. I don't think I do is y'all look at little videos and stuff with her and the kids and shit, because I be loving that shit. And I did steal her pasta recipe, honey. Honey, I had made it for one of my barbecues, and honey, the people was loving it. But honey, that might make me tune in a little more. I said, "Babe, oh, I see. You a roughneck. I love me a roughneck. Okay, and you all red and shit. Then you up here talking like a boss and address this. He ain't addressing the woman shit. He addressing this big back booty wide motherfucking nigga that stay in woman shit, been in woman shit from day one. He not the type of motherfucking nigga. Chris not the type of nigga that you could just kind of tell him the little girlfriend's business and shit, and he be like, damn, that's fucked up. And then when he see the chick come around, he got his nose turned up out and ready to say some slick and shit. You know what I'm saying? Like me, I can tell my husband some shit even though I don't have login. Even though I don't have no friends like talking, I had, you know, my one best friend. You know, I got people I associate and shit with. But I can tell him some shit or whatever. And he's not going to be on no shit like that. You know what I'm saying? And vice versa with me. He be telling me shit all the time about his friends and his partners and all that. When they come around, my attitude is not different to them. I'm speaking to them. Hey, what's up? You know what I'm saying? Unless it's a real beef now. I ain't laughing at a motherfucker face got a real beef with my nigga. You got beef with him. You got beef with me. That's how it go. But I'm just saying, you know, that little tater-tate, little bullshit and stuff like that. You know, I'm still speaking to them. It's nothing. You know what I'm saying? Not Chris. Chris ain't got shit else better to do. But you see, if Chris had him a real job, like a real man, he wouldn't have time for that. Come on, husband don't have time for that. And I feel like, I guess they've been saying, you know, Rod and left Chris. And I been knew it was bullshit when I seen it. But like I say, I'm going to support my fellow reactors. I'm going to look at their stuff. I'm going to like it and everything. So, it don't mean that I'm, you know, I agree with it or whatever. And I don't have to come in here and say that I don't agree with it. I'm just saying. But Rod not around because Rod ass is tired. That's how my husband is. He worked them fucking 12 hours through the week and them 8 hours on the weekend. He be tired. We could barely get anything out of him. Now, he will, like Chrissy had said, and I fell on that. My husband go work them 12 hours. He gonna come here and cut the yard. Now, he had a friend and everything that had a yard business, and he was trying to support his yard business, so he'll let him come over here and cut it and stuff like that too every now and then. But my husband will come here, cut the yard, take the boys out there, and they do the yard because all of them be out there doing the yard together. He will come here, change my tires, air my tires up, put gas in my car, all that other type of stuff. Even though y'all see me, I still be needing to go to the gas station and shit like that. But he do be putting, you know, my weekly gas and shit up in there and stuff like that. And, yeah, he still perform and do shit that he supposed to do and lollygag with his little friends about cars and shit. And, you know, I don't bother him. He don't bother me. We know when we need to think and come together and shit like that. The last past couple weeks, we've been kind of concentrating on the kids because, you know, it's time for the kids to go back to school. And we've been concentrating on what need to go down with the kids and then the kids' football games and shit like that. But I feel that. I said all that to say, Men being men fucking business. When they work hard, they too tired to be in bullshit. Okay? They too fucking tired to be in bullshit. Okay? I don't like that old feminine ass shit. That's why I always have called Chris out about that shit. In women being. Stay out women being. I done said that shit so many times in past videos. Chris, stay out a woman business. Stay out of woman business. Okay? Men that have jobs is not in woman business. If your bitch up here telling you some shit or some tea about her friend, you don't fucking bring it back to the front. When you said all them little old friend quotes and all that bullshit you were saying at the end of videos, everybody knew exactly what was going on. And for Jazz to sit up and allow that shit, I would never. That's one thing, another thing about me. I never mix the two. See, what you bitches got to learn, you can't mix the two. You can't mix your man relationship with bitches relationship. With your bitches. You can't do it. Now, it's okay if motherfuckers coming up for a barbecue and, you know, pouring up beer and daiquiris and having some laughs. But you never, never supposed to blend the fucking two. Okay? You never supposed to try to blend the fucking two. And Jazz gave Chris that fucking leeway to say shit like that because she go back and vent to him about what Chrissy said that she didn't like instead of saying it to Chrissy, her best friend. Because at the end of the day, when it's our best friends, we should be able to say whatever we want, however we feel. And if that's your friend, they gonna understand it or y'all gonna agree to this motherfucking agree. I can't be friends with somebody I feel like I gotta hold my motherfucking tongue about something. No, I'm not finna be up here like I'm your mama and telling you this and telling you that. But I can't be up here and be friends with somebody and I gotta watch what I say. I gotta walk on eggshells and all this shit. Bitch, just say what it is. Damn, Chrissy, I feel like this. Because I've been times like that. With my best friend, I said like this, and she'll be like, bitch, I wasn't even saying it like that. You know what I'm saying? And we'll work that shit and get that shit straight, and then we be back. Like, we never motherfucking left. You know what I'm saying? And that was what I respect and appreciate about our friendship that I wish I just would have appreciated it more when she was here, but I really appreciate it now that we could do that and give each other our space, and we could come back and talk that shit out. And say what the fuck it was and how we felt, and we be back like we never left off. You know what I'm saying? So it never was no big drag outs and shit like Chrissy and Jay got going. It never was no shit like that. But we had little disagreements and shit over the years, and you gotta understand, we was fucking friends ever since I was 15 years old. 15 years old. I wasn't even pregnant with my first daughter yet when we became friends. And my daughter is 24. So, yeah, we was friends for a long fucking time. She's seen a lot. She's been there for a lot. But anyway, I'm dragging on because I said that I'm supposed to be doing another video with some related to that and Jazz and friends and shit like that. But y'all know how I be getting long-winded about stuff that I be passionate about and stuff like that. Back to Chris. Chris, but you know, it just goes to show, you know what I'm saying, how he was raised in his environment. Maybe he was around a lot of women or something. Because I be saying it about my boys and shit. Even though they got their sisters and stuff like that, I don't want them to be the type of men that be just on women shit like that. And I get on them now and stuff. You know, I know people gonna come in and say, like, you gotta let black men have their feelings and not feel like they gotta be hard and all that. Yeah, but that's how I'm doing it over here. I was talking to my son the other day. It was like, you know what I'm saying? It's okay to have your feelings and stuff about stuff, but don't have feelings about every fucking thing, or not have feelings about everything. Don't feel like you got to address and lay your feelings about every fucking thing. At the end of the day, you are a man. You are a black man. You're going to soon have a family, and that family is going to be leaning in towards you to be strong for them. You're going to have daughters that's going to be looking for you to be strong for them. Don't nobody want no weak ass daddy. I don't want no weak ass daddy. I want me a strong daddy. When I be like, look, blah, 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 blah. And he like, what's up? Let's go. Let's go handle this shit. You know what I'm saying? So, yeah, I seen Chrissy over there like, I'm about to get you all this wick sloppy toppy tonight, nigga. Chrissy was even shocked that he said what he said. I just see it in her face. She was like, oh, please don't say too much. She wasn't saying too much like, don't say too much because she didn't want to offend Jay. She was saying like, okay, I'm not trying to lose no subs or no shit behind this. But you know, Rod stepped in like a real motherfucking man, said that one line and said what it was, and then he pulled the fuck back. He didn't elaborate. He didn't go on. He didn't prove his point or try to prove his point. Or, you know, did no ad libs. He said what he said. He laid that shit out there, and it was up to you to take it how you fucking want to take it. Look, I can read your ass and put you in your place. And then congratulate your accomplishments and everything in the same motherfucking breath. Ha! Let's give it up one time for Rod. as a good ass stepmom and doing the shit for the summer. Then we rolling in the motherfucking fall and riding, setting motherfucking niggas and putting them straight and telling them to stay out of bitch business. That's what the fuck I'm talking about. I was trying to start some shit this morning and Rod got it started for me. Thank you. Shit, y'all need to make Rod part of the Mommy Under Gang. Rod, you want to be a part of the Mommy Under Gang? Let's let you and Uriah start a Daddy Under. Yeah, Daddy Under. Step daddy and daddy on or some shit. I don't know. We're gonna figure this shit out. We gotta have a group for Uriah and motherfucking Rod over here. But yeah, Chris, what you where the clap back at, Chris? Y'all over there the bang trying to get the video together. I hope this video don't take long as the reveal. Like, I need some clap back. Like I told y'all earlier. Jay, don't be coming on this motherfucker talking about. This was Amaya the first day of school. This was the twins the first day in daycare. We don't wanna see that. What I want to see on my notification thing is Extra Jazz and Chris going live. And I want to see all the shit, the receipts, bitch. It's time for the receipts, bitch. Let's motherfucking go. Let's get it. Let's go. He punked you, Chris. This man just came and punked you on your platform. Ryan ain't got no motherfucking channel. Chris, you do. You gonna let him get away with it? You gonna let him get away with it? See, I knew you weren't about that motherfucking life. You all motherfucking bark and no goddamn bite. Literally with them big ass teeth. But, yeah, y'all. I may be leaving something out, but yeah. I just had to come on here. I've been in the YouTube streets all day. I'm up here now trying to get dressed and see what it, you know, my son, I really want to do nothing. I just want to see what he's trying to do or whatever. And yeah, I just had to come on here because I don't plan on being on YouTube tonight. Yeah. So, but you know me, I'm gonna be study trying to sneak on YouTube. But yeah, that was my little bullshit ass reaction. Y'all know I'm gonna have to come back with some more. I always say I'm gonna come back with some more. Yeah, fuck that. I'm coming back for some more. Y'all drop some shit in the comments, and I'm gonna come back with some more shit. Okay, y'all drop some shit in the comments. Yay, let's go, let's get it. Hey, that's how you start it. Hey, that's how you party. Hey, that's how you start a week. Oh, shout out to Rod for doing that. Big dick energy, okay? He, look, that's Kev got me on that big dick energy shit. Shout out to Sofa, big dick energy. Hey, let's get it started. I'm out.